Disability knows no boundary. Right now in Canada, there's over 4 million Canadians living with a disability, 1 in 7, according to Stats Canada. And these people have varying kinds of disabilities: mobility, visual, hearing, cognitive, or mental health issues. And aging baby boomers, they will have all kinds of issues that will create disabling conditions. They will have hearing loss, sight loss, strokes, Parkinson's, arthritis, Alzheimer's, and this number will accelerate between now and 2035. It will become 1 in 5 Canadians, and that will mean that it becomes a profound political and economic and cultural issue that will then mandate that people pay the attention to it and ensure that it's incorporated and normalized in order for the country to be empowered to reach our full potential. However, we can't measure where Canada stands relative to the world yet because, sadly, there's no formal index to measure how people are doing, how countries are doing related to becoming completely accessible. You know, when I had my accident in 1973, I had to shift from seeing pity to seeing possibility. And the country has largely evolved since the 70s and the 80s. When we brought our Constitution home in 1982, we actually explicitly stated that people with disabilities should be included as equals. Now seeing all kinds of examples where people with disabilities are leading in business, they're engaged in the arts, they're engaged in politics. As a matter of fact, the federal minister responsible for disability is a lawyer who's legally blind and is incredibly competent and talented. The mayor of the city of Vancouver, named Sam Sullivan, was a quadriplegic when he was sent to Torino to receive the Olympic flag for the 2010 Olympic and Paralympic Games. He had that flag placed in his electric wheelchair and flew the flag like any big city mayor would do. And he made us proud as Canadians that we had received this bid. He did his duty as a mayor, and we didn't have to say one thing about our values because it was being demonstrated. And these are great statements about how far Canada is coming. Canada's challenge as we continue to move forward to be completely accessible by 2050 is to ensure that our constitutional statement is backed up by consistent legislation, laws, and policies federally, and of course in every province and territory, and engaged at municipal levels and in our Aboriginal communities. And once we've done that, we've established what we call a minimum standard for a social safety net to say that we're not going to leave anyone behind, and people with disabilities are truly equal in our society, that people with disabilities have equal access to employment, equal access to drive our vibrant economy and build our vibrant culture. I believe we're halfway on the ultra marathon of social change. Hi, I'm Rick Hansen. I'm the founder and CEO of the Rick Hansen Foundation, and we're dedicated to a world that's accessible and inclusive for people with disabilities. Working towards an accessible and inclusive country is Canada.